Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. I'm Davey. Today I am sharing four or five different tips on how I keep my cloth diapers smelling fresh and how I get rid of that ammonia smell. So this is a little different video for me, but I've been hearing more and more people starting the cloth diapering. I have friends who cloth diaper and are looking into it, so I wanted to share what has worked for me. A little disclaimer is, like I said, this is what works for our family. If you do something completely different, if you don't use cloth diapers and you use disposable, you go for it. Whatever you need to do and whatever works for your family. I do use disposable when we travel, so I'm not anti-disposable, but this is what I do when we're home, and these are the tips I have for maintaining fresh smelling cloth diapers. So let me just share with you a little bit of the diapers I use first. So for my inserts, I use these type of diapers. I will put everything in the description box. I found most of my product and diapers on Amazon. And so I use the Love My brand. I have several other brands too, like Alba Baby, LLB, quite a few other different brands. Like this is an LBB outer cover, and how I do that is I put the cloth diaper one on the inside and then one in this part to help protect and trap that urine, poo, whatever you need to do on that. And I think that has worked really well for me and for my baby girl. She's actually not a baby, she's 17 months old now. So I've been doing cloth diapering for about 17 months. And then I also use these liners. These ones are great because you can just literally wipe them out and put a new liner in, especially when she was younger and wasn't peeing as much. But then I put two different liners in this one, a thinner one and a thicker one, inside that to trap anything that needs to be trapped. So those are my liners. And then I do have a diaper pail reusable bag that I'll explain how that works here when I wash that and everything out a little bit too. So first tip to maintaining healthy hygiene of your diapers is to wash regularly. So I wash every other day. If you're able to, I highly recommend washing every other day. If you can't, every 2 days. But that smell that builds in that diaper pail just really makes everything stink. And so I think that's one of the best ways to maintain a healthy smelling diaper. And so I will wash, like I said, every other day, how many ever I have in there, whether it be 8, whether it be 12, who knows. So I make sure to wash every other day. And about every 3 months, I use an ammonia buster called Funk Rock. Now, this is not a laundry detergent. So like I said, every 2 or 3 months, I will put all of my diaper inserts into boiling hot pots of water, and this takes a couple rounds for me because I have, well, probably 24 inserts and 10 liners, and I don't wash the liners in this, just the inserts. And so I will pour 4 tablespoons of this powder in there and let it boil, and then turn it down to a medium for about 40 minutes. And so I'll do that for all of my inserts, because that takes the ammonia out of the insert and gets rid of it. Yes, your house will smell a little bit for several hours after, but just open the windows, air it out. But having an ammonia booster, or not ammonia booster, an ammonia bouncer really helps with that. And this is good for sensitive skin. It's safe for babies, and not a laundry detergent though. All right, tip number 3 is to make sure that you get your diapers dry. I think a lot of people run into this issue where they don't dry them long enough, and so these inserts are a little wet on the inside, and so then if they don't dry it all the way, as soon as pee hits it, it smells. So how I wash and dry my diapers, this kind of goes along that line, is I'll throw everything in at once, including my diaper bag, and just flip that bag inside out, throw all your diapers in. I will wash it twice. So that's tip number 4. Do a 2-wash cycle. So my first wash is a heavy cold cycle, no laundry detergent, unless you wanted to use this as a pre-wash. You could do that, put like a tablespoon or two into your powder slot and let that run. And then I will do a hot wash with the laundry detergent, and I use a free and clear laundry detergent. Use whatever works for you and your child, and wash that on a hot cycle, like I said, and let it run. And then I will put everything into the dryer hot for about 60 to 70 minutes, depending on the power of your dryer. Now, if you live in an area where you can hang things on the line outside, please do that, actually, because the sun also helps suck out that ammonia. I just live close to a gravel road that's super busy, and it does not work with maintaining laundry outside and keeping it clean. So I highly recommend keep those diapers dry. Make sure they are completely dry, and if you can, put them in the sun. Tip number 5 would be just to, this is my personal opinion, get a spray nozzle to help keep your pooey diapers clean. So I have a spray nozzle that connects to my toilet, and I spray off the poo diapers into the toilet. It's so helpful. I know this is like a first world convenience, but it really truly has been extremely helpful. Like I said, I'll put all this stuff in the description box. That helps get rid of that extra stench that's on there. So I hope this was helpful. I've had lots of friends who are wanting to cloth diaper, who have been, but they run into issues of the smell and then they stop. I hope that you can maintain and keep the smell at bay, because that's the best way to go. And also, ammonia really burns the little bumps of the babies, and you don't want that on there, because you want to make sure your baby is safe and not getting a rash from that. Like I said, this is a little different video for me, but I hope you found it informative. If you have more questions about cloth diapering, I could get into a whole nother segment on the money saving factors and how it's really worked well for our family, but this is more about maintaining and keeping the ammonia smell at bay. Then let me know in the comments if you have other tips. I would love to hear that in the comments below too. So hope you have a blessed and wonderful day, and I'll talk with you in my next video. Bye.